Zeus was the Greek god of the sky and ruler of the Olympian gods, but he also had quite a knack for handling lightning. Could humans ever harness the power of a god? Could we ever control lightning? Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Lightning is one of the most fearsome and enigmatic forces of nature. Since Benjamin Franklin first flew his kite into the stormy skies some night long ago, we've been fascinated by the idea of taming lightning. Cloud-to-ground lightning bolts are a common phenomenon. About 100 strike Earth's surface every single second with a force of a billion volts of electricity, which can do some nasty damage to stuff on the ground. And some studies show that lightning could increase by 50% thanks to global warming. Lightning happens because storm clouds are charged in the atmosphere. The top tends to be positive and the bottom negative. But I won't go into all the details because Trace explains it all in this great episode right here. With incidents of lightning on the rise, it makes sense we would want to control it. What if we could direct the path of lightning? Well, not surprising, but scientists are working on it. Specifically, they are working on controlling lightning with lasers. Back in 2008, a bunch of French scientists took huge lasers into the New Mexican desert. When they fired them into storm clouds, they noticed that they increased electrical activity in the clouds. Unfortunately, lightning didn't happen. So they scaled things down and took it back to the lab. In another experiment, they fired an electrical charge between two electrodes. Normally, the charge would go straight from one electrode to the other, but by firing a laser 5 to 20 centimeters close to the electrode, the charge jumped to the laser before hitting the other electrode. This showed that lasers could have some effect on the trajectory of an electrical charge. Okay, yeah, so nothing that terribly exciting, but in a more recent study published in the journal Science Advances, other researchers harnessed more control over the trajectory of an electrical charge. In a proof-of-concept experiment, the researchers fired charges between two electrodes only centimeters apart. They fired a laser through that electrical charge to guide its path. The lasers ionize the air, and as the charge goes between the electrodes, it follows the path of the least resistance, along the trajectory determined by the laser beam. They used several types of laser beams to create differently shaped paths. Gaussian beam, Bessel beam, and an airy beam. In the Gaussian beam, the charge looked kind of like a normal charge. In the Bessel beam, though, it made the charge follow a straight path. An airy beam made the charge follow a parabola shape. Putting two airy beams together, though, made the charge follow a sweet S shape. But what's really cool is that the airy and Bessel type beams self-heal, meaning that once they encounter an obstacle, they can go around it and reform like nothing even happened. So the charge wasn't stopped by something in its way. So yeah, we're talking on the scale of centimeters here, nothing that dramatic. Humans won't be Zeus quite yet. So while it's a long way away from controlling lightning, it's certainly a cool start. So remember how I mentioned how global warming is causing more lightning? Matt Lieberman has more on that in this D News episode right here.
Increased global temperatures will cause more water to evaporate into the atmosphere. Imagine a bomb dropped into a barrel of gunpowder in one of those old school rooms that's just packed to the gills with TNT in a house that's on fire. You get the picture.
How awesome would it be to control lightning? Tell us how sweet it would be down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here to D News so you don't miss a single episode.